Welcome to the video tutorial on creating an OPNsense virtual firewall in Windows Hyper-V. I instruct you to create a virtual firewall that resembles a physical device with different interfaces. Computers on the local network can access the internet through the one interface. Let's get started. First, visit the OPNsense homepage and download this firewall installation ISO file. Make sure your Windows computer has the Hyper-V hypervisor installed. In the Hyper-V hypervisor, I create virtual switches to connect the different interfaces of OPNsense. I open the Virtual Switch Manager on Hyper-V and created a new virtual switch named LAN. OPNsense SLAN interface connects to this Hyper-V virtual switch. Next, I create a new virtual switch named WAN. OPNsense S1 interface connects to a virtual switch called WAN and allows computers in the local network to access the internet. After completing the creation of two virtual switches, I created a new OPNsense virtual machine. This virtual machine has a minimum memory of 2 GB. The OPNsense virtual machine will be connected to a virtual switch called LAN. In the following step, I will connect the virtual machine to the virtual switch called WAN. This virtual machine's hard drive has a minimum size of 20 GB. Next, navigate to the OPNsense installation file downloaded to your Windows computer in the previous step. I have finished creating the OPNsense virtual machine, but it only has one network interface, so I will add a new one. I opened the OPNsense virtual machine settings and added a new network interface. This network interface connects to a virtual switch called WAN. Make sure the virtual machine boots from the CD drive to begin installing OPNsense. It's time to install the operating system for this virtual machine. I start and connect to it. You wait until a command prompt appears asking to log in. To install OPNsense on your hard drive, use the username installer and password OPNsense. Follow these steps to install OPNsense on the virtual hard drive. I deleted the data on the virtual hard drive and started installing OPNsense. Once completed, restart the virtual machine. I will shut down the virtual machine and remove the installation files from the virtual machine. I do this to ensure the virtual machine boots from the hard drive. You open the OPNsense virtual machine settings and remove the ISO file. Then you set up the virtual machine to boot from the hard drive. I use a Windows virtual machine connected to a virtual switch called LAN. Thus, the Windows virtual machine connects to OPNsense via the LAN interface. It is like physical device, the computers connect to OPNsense via LAN interface. Computers are allocated IP addresses and access the internet through the OPNsense firewall. On the Windows virtual machine, I open any browser and connect to the OPNsense firewall. If the subnet of the local network and the external network are the same like me, then follow these steps. I change the subnet of the local network. I change the default IP address on the LAN interface. Next, I changed the IP address range in the DHCP server configuration according to the new subnet. After applying the changes, computers in the local network can access the internet through OPNsense. Above are the basic steps to create an OPNsense virtual machine in Windows Hyper-V. It's like a physical firewall. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Good luck.